Hi, welcome to bluepenbluemarker. In this session of bluepenbluemarker, we are discussing 12th cbse boards, because the examination is at hand and we were discussing vectors. So let's see some questions regarding vectors. Okay, the first question is, here is given. This question describes that if question one is given, it's been given that if A equal to I minus 2j, okay, plus k, and B equal to, this is I minus j, and this is plus k, okay, then find a vector which is perpendicular to both. The question says, find a vector which is perpendicular to both this and this. This is possible when okay, this is the vector, and this vector is A and this vector is B, okay, and one vector which is perpendicular to both vectors, this is the vector, and this vector is given by A cross B upon modulus of A cross B. Okay, this is the required vector. This is also called unit vector. Okay, or we can simply write it like this, it's B. If it is A, this is B. This is the vector which is perpendicular to both this and this. Okay, both these vectors are perpendicular to this vector is perpendicular to both the vectors. So we have to find the vector which is perpendicular to both. So we have to find what? A cross B upon A cross B modulus. So first of all, we calculate A cross B. So let's calculate A cross B. So what is A cross B? It's I, J, and then K, okay? So this will be, I is what? The square components of A is 1, minus 2, and 1. Clear? And the square component of B is 1 minus 1, 1. So let's calculate it. This will be I. Okay. We delete it. So minus 2 minus minus plus 1. Just we are expanding the determinant. Okay. Minus J. Clear? You know it. There is no doubt. Okay. So 1 minus 1. Clear? Comes to K. Delete it like this. So minus 1 plus 2. So the answer will be minus 2 plus 1 minus I. Clear? And is 1 minus 1 0? J is out. That means minus 0 J. Or simply you can write plus 0 J. No problem. And plus K. This, finally we can write minus I plus K. This is the vector A cross B. And then A cross B modulus. A cross B modulus. So this modulus will be minus 1 square plus 1 square under root. You know the modulus, it's very simple. So 1 plus 1 is under root 2. Clear? We got A cross B and then A cross B modulus. So the required vector. So the required vector is A cross B upon modulus of A cross B. This will be minus I plus K upon root 2. This we can write it like minus 1 by root 2 I plus 1 by root 2 J. This is the required vector. Okay, any problem? It's very much simple, no problem. So this vector is the vector which is perpendicular to both these vectors. Okay, let's see the next question. you got it? Any problem? I think there is no problem. Okay, so the next question says, let's rub it first. The next question is, So question number two says so it is been given if the question is if A cross B modulus equal to A dot B modulus is given, then the angle between vector A and B is a two marker. Is very much simple. If A cross B equal to A dot B. Okay, so let's explain. Since A cross B modulus equals to A dot B modulus. Okay, this is modulus of A, modulus of B into sine theta. Clear? And unit vector, modulus of unit vector becomes 1. So here will be modulus of A, modulus of B, this is cos theta. Okay. So simply we can cancel it. So sine theta by cos theta is what? Sine theta by cos theta. This will be 1, implies tan theta equal to 1. If tan theta equal to 1, clearly theta equal to pi by 4. So this is the angle between these two vectors. If A cross B equal to A dot B modulus. This question may come for a two marker or simply as an objective question. Okay. This is that much simple. So let's rub this part and we are moving to the next question. All these questions are a two marker, either a two marker or an objective. Sometimes you can get the idea, basic idea, to solve the four markers. Now let's move to the next question. The question says the question is if it's been given, it's very much simple. It's given. Question number 3 is given. Modulus of A is given, it's under root 3, and modulus of B is given, it's 2. And angle between A and B is given 60 degree. So the required question is, what is A dot B? Is that much simple? Very much simple. Since we know A dot B equal to mod of A mod of B into cos theta. Okay, so mod of A is root under root 3, it's 2, and what is cos theta then? Cos 60 degree. This will be root 3 into 2 into 1 by 2. 2 gets out. This is under root 3. So this is you got dot product of A and B. That much simple. I think it's a very simple question. You can do it. So let's move to the because we want to move from easier to harder ones. Okay, because we are doing this easy questions, making up the base, and then we move to the harder problems. Okay, now another question says projection of question number 4, projection of A on B. Okay, and A has been given 3i minus 2j plus k, and B is given 2i plus 3j plus k. Is that much simple? You can do it. Look now, projection of A on B. So we know that projection of A on B is given by A dot B cap. Clear? Because so this will be A dot modulus of B by modulus of B. Clear? B by modulus of B. So this will be A dot B by modulus of B. Okay, this implies what is A dot B? 3 into 2 A1 A2 3 into A1 A2 B1 B2 C1 C2, plus minus 2 into 3, clear, and then plus 1 into 1, clear, upon modulus of B. So this will be 2 square plus 3 square plus 1 square under root. So this will be 3 to the 6, 6 is out, 1 1 is a 1. This will be 1 upon 2 to the 4, 9, 13, 14 under root. So this is the projection of this vector on this vector. I think you got it. If you have any problem, you can make a comment. Simple projection of A on this vector B. A dot B cap, that means A dot B by modulus of B. Got it? Okay. So let's move to the next part. Next question. The question should be okay. The question is is very good question. It's also called Lagrange's identity. Question 5 is Lagrange's identity is a good question. It's maybe a four marker. So is this identity says A cross B whole square plus A dot B whole square equal to mod of A square and mod of B square. We have to prove it. So we take the LHS A cross B, because we have to prove it. So we take the LHS A cross B whole square plus A dot B whole square. Any problem? No problem. So by the definition of cross product, mod of A mod of B sine theta into unit vector n is whole square plus mod of A mod of B cos theta whole square. This is cos theta. Clear? Okay. Now what we do is simply mod of A square mod of B square sine square theta into cap whole square. Clear? Plus mod of A square mod of B square, this will be cos square theta. So taking mod of A square mod of B square outside, common, taking it common, so this will be sine square theta. Okay, plus and square of unit vector is 1, so this will be it is taken out, so this will be cos square theta. So this is mod of A square mod of B square into 1, because sine square theta plus cos square theta is 1, so this will be mod of A square and mod of B square. So this is the required result. We got the result. This is called Lagrange's identity. It's very much important and very good question. Okay, next, move to the next part. I think you are getting it. Now let's move to the next part. These are exam oriented questions, because we are moving from easier one to harder one, harder questions. And now the question says okay, it is okay, one very good question is been given. If question number 6 is been given, if A plus B plus C is zero vector? It's an important question, triple start question. And then to prove A cross B equal to B cross C equal to C cross A. Prove this. It's a very good question. So let's do it. Now since is been given, since A plus B plus C equal to zero vector. Okay. Taking cross product, we can write it like this: A cross A plus B plus C equal to A cross zero vector. Okay, clear? Any problem? So A cross A plus A cross B plus, then this will be A cross C. This will be A cross zero is zero vector. Clear? A cross zero is zero vector because zero vector. Now A cross A. What is A cross A? Mod of A sine 0 degree. So sine 0 is what? 0. This will become 0 plus A cross B plus AB BC CA. If it is CA, if we take it in cyclic order means if A is here, B is here, C is here. Okay, A to B, B to C, then C to A. It is A cross B, B cross A cross B, B cross C, C cross A. But it is A cross C. If you do it like C cross A, so there will be negative sign. Why? Because cross product is not commutative. Cross product is not commutative. So A cross B is not equal to B cross A. A cross B equal to minus B cross A. Clear? Okay. So now this will become A cross B will be equal to C cross A. This is, take it, equation 1. Clear? Very much clear. Now again. A plus B plus C equal to zero vector. Now this time we are going to take a B. We multiplied it. We took cross product of A. Now we are taking with B. B cross A plus B plus C equal to zero vector. Okay. So this will become B cross A plus B cross B. Why? B cross A, B cross B plus B cross C. Clear? It will be zero vector. Clear? Okay. Let's move to the next. Okay. Now let's see. This is B cross A. B cross A. Oh. B cross A. B cross A plus. This will be B. A. B cross B is 0. Why? B cross B, same thing, because both the vectors are same. So modulus of B sine 0 degree 0. So 0 vector plus B cross C is 0 vector. So this, can we write like this, minus A cross B? Why? Because A cross B is not commutative. This will be B cross C is 0. This further implies B cross C will be equal to A cross B. Take it in the on the right side. So this is equation 2. If you see from the equation 1 and equation 2, from 1 and 2, we find that A cross B equal to C cross A, and A cross B equal to B cross C. So A cross B, B cross C and C cross C, all three are equal. So A cross B equal to B cross C equal to C cross A. This was our desired result. This was to be proved, and we came to the result. This is the result. From A plus B plus C equal to 0, we took two things. First cross, first took A, we took this A plus B plus C equal to 0, cross multiplied by what? We took A and then multiplied, then again we took B. We also can take C, the same result will appear. So I think you have got each and every point of this question. There is no problem. If you have any problem, you can ask. Now let's move to the next part. The next question that comes in our way is a good question. Is a very good question that comes our way. So sometimes you are asked as a two marker. It comes as a two marker. The question is. Let's do it here. The question is find the angle. Question 7 is find the angle between is given A is given I minus J plus K. There may be any vector is been given. It's a simple example. Okay, you got the gist. B equal to I plus J minus K. Okay, you have to find the angle between them. So simply we know that A dot B equal to mod of A mod of B. It's very simple using dot product. Okay, from here cos theta will be, because theta is the angle between them, so cos theta will be equal to A dot B upon modulus of A modulus of B. So what is A dot B? Simple, 1 into 1, A1, A2, B1, B2, C1, C2. So plus minus 1 into 1, okay, plus 1 into minus 1, clear, good, upon modulus of A, 1 square plus minus 1 square plus 1 square, under root, in then comes, this will be 1 square plus 1 square plus minus 1 square. Okay, this will be 1 into 1, 1, 1 into 1, 1, 1, 1 gets out, so it will be minus 1. Okay, this will be minus 1, this will be minus 1. Okay, minus 1 upon 1 plus 1 plus 1, under root 3 into under root 3. Again, it's the same thing, minus 1 by 3. Clear? So then the angle between these two vectors comes out to be minus 1 by 3. Cos theta is, so the theta will be, using ITF, inverse trigonometric function, cos inverse minus 1 by 3. Okay, so this is the required angle between these two vectors. It's a simple question and it's important also. Now let's move to the next question. Okay. Let's come to the end. So the guys and my students who are preparing for the CBSE boards, whose examination is at hand, is right the corner, around the corner. So it will help you in your preparation from easy to harder questions. So it is the area where we focus on vectors. Okay. now it's very much simple. Now the question comes. Okay, it's been given that the question is simple, you know it. It's very much simple. A plus B plus C, you can do it. Now let's move to the next part. Okay, this question is again the same thing, we can do it. Now one another version of Lagrange's identity. Look, another version of Lagrange's identity. okay lagrange's identity, okay, is another version of lagrange's identity was a cross b is square plus a dot b square. It was mod of a square and mod of b square. That means simply a square b square. Okay, clear? Now the another version is a cross p modulus square equal to determinant of a dot a, okay, a dot b. So this will be a dot b and this is b dot b. Same thing. If you take this determinant, the right side, you can easily and very easily prove this result. Why? A dot a, b dot b, multiply, then a dot b whole square, bring it like this, okay. So taking the RHS, you can simply solve it. Like if you take the RHS, taking the RHS right hand side, okay, this is what a dot a. So a dot a, clear? A dot b, this is what, this is a dot b and then b dot b. It's that much simple. Multiply then a dot a into b dot b minus a dot b whole square. Clear? So a dot a is modulus of a square, b dot b is modulus of b square minus a dot b is here. Clear? Okay, there is no problem. So if you move to the next step, modulus of a square modulus of b square minus, so this is mod of a mod of b cos theta whole square. Clear? I think there should be no problem. And then if you move further, we can do it like this will be modulus of a square, okay, modulus of b square minus modulus of a square modulus of b square, and this will be cos square theta. Taking out modulus of a square modulus of b square, taking out 1 minus cos square theta. Clear? Okay, though this will be mod of a square mod of b square, this will be 1 minus cos sine square theta. Okay, can you write 1? Very good. Mod of a mod of b sine theta, and about 1 is unit vector, then it's whole square. Can we write it like this? Of course we can, because our target is what, a cross b. So I have to manage the formula. I multiplied by 1 is the modulus of unit vector. Now this a b whole square, so this is what, a square b square sine square theta into 1 square. Is that much simple? Now and the whole thing is a cross b modulus, this is the whole square. Okay, so we got the result. It is the another version of Lagrange's identity. This question can be asked in two ways, either in this way or in this way. Both are very simple. Okay, now let's move to the next question. It's a question it's a very good question. So so the question has been given. Okay, so the question, now next question is regarding vectors. One more question is there. This is, you can do it, so there is no problem. All these are very simple questions. So next, let's move to the next question.
It's very simple. Now one thing, one more thing is there, that the question that comes, that is important. Okay, I think you've got the idea. Now the question says, I think eighth question, if the sides A 2i minus j plus k, okay, and is b is given 3i plus 2j plus 5k is been given, okay. These are the adjacent sides of a parallelogram. This is the parallelogram, adjacent sides of a parallelogram. So we need to find, the required question is, what is the area of parallelogram? It's a very good question. So we can find the area. So area of parallelogram. So area of parallelogram equals A cross B modulus. So first of all, we have to find A cross B. So A cross B is what? Again, same thing. Determinant I, J, then K. Okay, what is I, J, K? The scalar component is 2, minus 1, 1. This is what? 3, 2, 5. Solve it fast. I. This. Okay, hide it. Minus 5, minus 5, minus 2. This is minus 5. Minus. Hide it. Minus 5, minus 2. Minus J. So this will be J. 5 to the 10, minus 3, okay, plus K, this will be 2 to the 4, plus 3, clear? Now, 5 minus 2, minus 7i, minus 7j, and plus 7k. So, this is the factor A cross B. Now what we need, area of parallelogram. So this is A cross B modulus. So what is the modulus of A cross B? This will be minus 7 whole square plus minus 7 whole square plus 7 whole square under root. 49 plus 49 under root. So this will be 3 times 49 under root. So this will be 7 under root 3 unit square. Why unit square? Because it is the area. I think you got it. Okay. So all these questions are there, and these are the basic questions, and your preparation can go on from the easier ones to harder ones. So guys, preparing for those the CBSE is a CBSE boards 2019. You can go through all these questions. Okay, we are shortly bringing to you 3Ds, 3D. Vector is going on 3D. Then probability. Then we come to the calculus part. And quick. We are coming quickly to you with the algebra, matrices, and determinants. Then ITF, inverse trigonometric functions. Then your first two chapters, relations and functions. So wait for the next videos. If you like them, if you like this class, like it. And finally, I can say that subscribe our channel, and we bring to you all these types of questions and all these types of problems that regarding your examination 2019 CBSE boards. Thank you. Thank you for watching. Thank you. Bye-bye.